Hi, good afternoon. So today we are going to study the PID control on the flow system. So basically PID control is to control the output of some systems based on the errors to prevent or minimize the erroneous system in the flow system. And nowadays, a lot of machines such as pump, water pump, or flow meter, or thermometer, they use the PID controller to control their output to minimize or prevent any errors in the system. So today we are going to use the PID control to study the flow meter of this pump.
My name is Adira. My matrix number is 188289. So basically, I will talk about the equipment of apparatus that we are doing in the flow control experiment. This is the machine of a level of flow control trainer. Basically, what we use in this is that the switch here, we have to switch, turn it on. And then some more, this is the drain valve in which then after once the result has been reported, has been noted, we will drain the valve first, right here, and then we have to on and off the pump start and also off and on of the isolator. Okay, for this experiment, we use the AQ master to see the result of the flow. Okay, first, after we on the equipment, we can adjust the PID, which is the proportional band. And heating integral time and heating derivation time for PI, we use 6 degrees for P and 0 second for integral time. Also for the PID, we use 6 degree for heating proportional band, 6 second for integral time, and we change the time to 1, 2 and 3 seconds. So we can see the result here and we can save the result to the computer. That's all.
So this is the result that we got by using the DAQ software. So as we can see right here, when the proportional is 2, the time taken for it to reach the desired set, which is 2 seats, is longer compared to when the proportional is 4 and also when the proportional is 5. So it means that when the proportional is increased, time taken for it to reach our desired level, which is 6, is faster compared to when it